Duolingo is worth over $23 billion. And in this video, we are going to clone it using the AI app builder Rork. My initial prompt is I want to build a language learning app like Duolingo with fun quizzes. Let's start with learning Spanish. I want it to be gamified like Duolingo. So, very simple initial prompt. I'm going to send that into Rork. And on the left side, Rork is going to start sharing its plan and start building the app. On the right side, you can test it on your phone and actually see it in the preview. What's really great about Rork is that you can actually upload the final app to the iOS App Store or the Google Play Store. Rork is, in my opinion, one of the best AI app builders for actually uploading to the App Store so users can use your app natively on their phone. Be sure to stick around. You're going to want to see the final result that we create. Here we are with our first version of the app that Rourke created. We have a homepage. We have a lessons page with, it looks like it created a handful of lessons here in different categories. And then we have a profile page with points, lessons, progress, and streaks, which is awesome because the gamification is something that makes Duolingo really sticky. So let's jump into a lesson. Basics, how do you say hello in Spanish? Hola, check answer, correct. Cool. Translate thank you to Spanish. Let's actually just test it. So let's just put in the wrong answer. That's pretty cool. So it actually had this built in with the correct answer. We'll go next. Match the words to their translations. This is interesting. I don't know. Okay, simplified for demo. So let's say, make sure the match to words to translations actually works in the app. So that's just a simplification, I guess, but pretty cool. So that lesson, and we have points and we have a streak set. So let's try to fix this. Make sure the match to words to translation actually works in the app. Also, please provide some introduction, like teaching before the quiz so that students learn the material. So let's have it update the app in those ways. I'll pause the video and we'll come back in a second. All right, so it says that this is resolved. One thing that I really like about Rourke is there's a code inspector that runs every single time that it finishes a task. So it did find an error, I fixed it, and then now it seems like it fixed it. So let's test it out. Let's go into lesson two. So let's go into lesson two. Let's just test it out. Cinco, next. Good morning. Let's just get the answer wrong just to test that. Buenos dias. Perfect. Next. And then the matching is still, so I'm going to send it this screenshot. I'm going to say, I just took a picture. I'm going to say, the matching still says it's for the demo. And let's see what it says to this. Then one thing is we need to make sure that we go back to Sonnet. Because for Grok, we can't add photos. So that's one thing on the bottom left here. You can change the AI model. We were using Grok, which is very good at coding, not as good at design. Now we're going to switch to Sonnet 3.7. Okay, so here we are. We are going to test this again. So I refreshed the app on the top and I went back and forth a little bit just to make sure it updated the lessons. So let's start and we go to basics. So now it has this introductory vocabulary so that we're giving the student a chance to learn before they get started. We'll click start quiz. We'll take the first one. We'll do the second one. And amazing. This is what I was hoping for. So now we have to match the words to their translations. So yes, is C. And there we go. It's all correct. And we continue. Now we can go into the second lesson. So it's all working perfectly now. So we have the quiz. Let's just see if this gets wrong. Okay, perfect. And then the matching, perfect, and it's all mixed up. So very cool that that all works correctly. And we can see we have our points showing up and our streak, and we have our lessons with the green bar to show us how our progress is. And then we have a profile as well. And then here we have some achievements. So pretty cool that that's all working. So a few things that we could add on to this. Why don't we just try to work on the design? So I'm going to say, let's make this the Sonnet 3.7 model. I'm going to say the design is okay, but let's really make it pop the way that Duolingo does. Don't change any functionality, only improve the design. And I'll pause the video and we'll come back when this is finished. So here we are with the redesigned app. had to go back and forth a little bit. Just one thing I did was I took a screenshot of the lessons page when it didn't scroll, and then it just fixed it. And here we have our streak, daily goal. Just everything about this design is a lot better. So I click on basics. We have a nice little introduction with a learning tip, which I really like. If I click start quiz, this looks a lot more like Duolingo, which I just think it looks really good. We have a really nice clicked states here. Really nice. Okay, let's type the answer. Oh, it's like a little bug, actually. That doesn't work. And then let's see if this works. So it looks like there was a little bug introduced there, but let's try to get it wrong. Okay, yep, and that didn't work. And that does work if I do it right. So cool. So I'll check the answer and continue. And we have XP. So just overall, the design is a lot better. It did introduce that one bug, but that could be fixed pretty easily. And then here we have family, for example. And yeah, this is all really, really nice. A few things that I would recommend doing if you're following along next. One, we can go up to the top right. We could do integrations and we could add a backend to the app. So by doing this, you're going to allow users to log in, save all of their information to their own account. Right now, this is just on, basically there's no login, so it's just all based on the session. That's something we did in our first Rork video. So check out our channel to see how to do this. It's really as simple as enabling it and following the steps. So that's something that I would recommend doing. Of course, we'd want to build on more lessons, which we could ask the AI to do. We could also build out like a little admin page where we could create lessons ourselves, or perhaps even use something like OpenAI to create the lessons. That's something that I would recommend. So those are some things that we could do to build off of this. And then, of course, once you're ready, you can publish it to the App Store using Rork. We made a lot of progress in just over 10 minutes. I'm really impressed by what this AI app builder can do. Of course, there's a lot more we would need to do to get to feature parity with Duolingo, but for 10 minutes, this is really impressive. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free videos like this. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. If there's any ideas of what you want me to build next, let me know as well in the comments. If you want to build an AI app but don't have any ideas, I've put together a list of 59 validated AI business ideas. Click the link in the description, enter your email, and you'll get that for free. If you have an AI app idea but don't have the time to build it yourself, we also have a link in the description to match you to an AI app developer who can build your idea for you. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.